are pretty much done with drawing the tiny house at this point for what we're going to do to get at the very least the framing up. So I just wanted to give you a little like higher level overview of what we've done here. So our tiny house is 28 feet long. The trailer is 28 feet long. And with the cantilevers over here, we got about approximately 32 feet of length at its longest. It is probably just about exactly 13 and a half feet tall. I think I might have come in just under that or over that. Let's see here. Coming from the top. All the way down to the bottom of that tire. We're talking just over 13 feet. But I don't have like the roofing on yet, so the standing seam roof will add like another inch or so. So we're gonna be under 13 and a half feet, which is good for the DMV. And we are under 102 inches wide. I still need to get the board and batten on the side here. So once that's on, that's gonna add like another, what was it, like half inch, 1 inch, plus about another 2.5 inches onto the width. Right now we're at 8'3", so we're at like 99 and a half inches. So we add another 3 inches, we got basically 102. So that's what we're dealing with here. 102 inches wide by 28 foot trailer and 32 foot with the cantilevers on each side. You can see where our front door is at, right there. You can see that we got a couple nice big windows looking into our like living room area. On this side, we got a couple nice little 2x2 windows, 2 foot by 2 foot square windows for the bathroom. And on the top level, we got these awning windows, which like the two windows in the center, those are gonna be picture windows. They're not gonna be operable. But the awning windows on either side where our lofts are gonna be are going to be operable. And they swing out like that. They kind of swing up. That's what the awning window is. All the other windows are going to be casement windows where they basically swing out like a door. So some of these are pretty big. This one right here, this is going to be an awning window, not a casement, but I think the rest are all casement windows. Yeah, these three are casement windows, but this guy right here, that's an awning window. Sorry, that's a picture window. That one's not going to be operable, and you'll see why when we come around. And, yeah, that's it. Okay, so let's enter the house. We're going to use SketchUp's walk tool to walk in here. And actually, I'm going to use the position camera just to hop in real quick. And I'm going to set the eye height, as you can see in the lower right, to 5'6", which is 66 inches. I'm going to do that because that is my eye height. I'm about 5'10", give or take, and my eyes are about 4 inches down from the top of my head. All right, so now we're going to use the look around tool to see what we're working with here. Oh, before we do that, for drawing, I generally have my camera's field of view set to 35 degrees. Oh, actually, I already are set to 75. Okay. So yeah, when we're inside the house, like looking around, I like to set it to 75 degrees field of view. It's like it's a wider angle view, more fisheye-ish, which allows you to see more. So now let's use the look around tool and we can see our kitchen right there. And we see our stairs going up to our bedroom loft. We see our living room area over here. And this way we got another set of stairs, a steeper set of stairs, going up to our second loft, which is going to be a few different purposes over the course of time. And then of course we have our bathroom right over here. So let's walk into the bathroom. Now I don't have everything drawn out here, but because again, this was just to get all of our framed openings established and figure out and to draw the framing. And I'm gonna get started on that first. I'm taking this step by step because I don't wanna even try to, I'm not a seasoned builder. I'm an amateur for the most part. So I want to take this step by step and kind of just see, once we get the framing done, I'll kind of go from there. So the bathroom is 5 foot wide. I think the entire house is 7 foot. Let's see here, on the interior finished walls, we're talking 7 foot 5 and a half. The entire house is 7 foot 5 and a half wide on the interior. And so our bathroom is 5 foot by 7 and a half, 7 foot 5 and a half. Whoops, didn't mean to do that. 66 inches high height, okay. All right, so we got our tub and shower. And we have our area where we're going to have a vanity and a toilet. And that toilet is not going to be a composting toilet. We are going to be hooking into our septic. So we are just, I'm just going to plumb it straight down and out to the septic. Okay, so that's the bathroom. Okay, so let's take a look around. We have a washer-dryer combo. It's an interesting technology that I'm curious to see how well it works. I've read about it. The dryer is a condensation dryer, and apparently clothes can come out of it feeling a little bit damp. So in a worst case scenario, I guess we're going to have to line dry. In the wintertime, we'll probably just deal with it. And hopefully what people mean by damp is not actually damp. It's probably just slightly damp. It probably, hopefully will just dry inside, no problem. Looking at the rest of the kitchen, let's actually, in order to look at the kitchen, let's do something a little different. Let's exit the tiny house and let's use the section plane. I've showed this a whole bunch of times before. I'm gonna set my field of view temporarily back to 35 degrees just to make everything a little bit nicer to look at now that we're gonna use our section plane. So we're gonna use our section plane tool. Where'd that go? Section plane, lock that to the red axis, and we're going to move that like so. Section plane allows us just take a cross section, set a plane through our model, and get a cross section of it. And what I like to do when I'm selecting stuff, I like to hide this guy because it gets in the way, and we're not going to cover that today. So now you can get a really good view of what our kitchen looks like. Oh, you see how I actually should have gone a little further. You can still see a bit of that washer. So let me unhide that section plane. And I'm going to move it out just a little bit. Move it in just a little bit. There. Okay, so what you're looking at here for our kitchen is we got base cabinets. We got three base cabinets. Well, four base cabinets, actually. We're doing this all from IKEA. Doing that to save money and to simplify, and IKEA's got nice modern looks. This is going to be a temporary house for us for anywhere from a few to maybe 5 years. So we don't want to, we're not trying to go too crazy. I'm going to try and do as little custom as possible. There's going to be a lot of custom in this house, but whatever I can do not custom, I'm going for it. So we got these IKEA base cabinets. We got four of them right here. So we got 24 inches of countertop space there, 30 inches there. And then this thing over here is a really big countertop, and that is approximately 7 feet. We got a 36-inch sink in there, and that is really big for a tiny house, but we feel that the kitchen should be a place that is very usable, and we didn't want to skimp on kitchen stuff. So we're going to have the ability to have a drain basket in that second sink and or use it to do more washing, bigger pots and stuff. We're going to have a 30-inch stove and range, and that is also really crucial to the whole kitchen accessibility thing for us. So that's that. Right above the stove, this box represents an exhaust range hood. It's going to be an outside exhaust going straight outside out the wall. And, you know, I'd like to get something really powerful like 600 CFM. I think that's what I got in Taos, if I remember correctly, for the Earthship. But we'll see. I think, you know, we might just go with an IKEA version of that as well. We might go with IKEA for all these appliances, or at least for the stove, oven, and the sink, and the exhaust hood, just to simplify. We also like the way it looks, and we have some family that has IKEA stuff, and it seems to be working fine for many years. IKEA has this exhaust range hood that just looks like a cabinet. It literally is just built into a cabinet. You don't see anything. So we kind of like that idea. That's why it's represented as just this box right here. And then we just got some wall cabinets up here with normal, doors for storage. We got this shelf right here, exposed shelf, because we're gonna put. We're not gonna have a whole purification filtering system for our well water here. We are gonna be catching rainwater, but there's issues with that too. We are gonna have some rudimentary, like just spin down mesh filtering to get rid of like debris. We're only gonna be using that like well water slash rainwater for washing. We're not gonna drink it. So what we're gonna have to do is there's a local well that's available to the public, and we go and fill up jugs of water, and we're just gonna have like a 2 gallon simple little reservoir spigot thing on this shelf right here, and maybe a couple other tchotchkes, or not tchotchkes because those are kind of just taking up room, or maybe tchotchkes because Justine likes them. We'll see what goes on that shelf. But you got to be careful with stuff in the kitchen because, you know, it gets real dusty real fast. And you got to clean everything. And also you got all that like oil and gunk that comes from the range when you're cooking fatty stuff and spatter, and it gets in the air and it just sits on stuff. So, you know, everything's got to be clean that's exposed. All right. So that's the kitchen. One thing to note about this, this fender is that we're gonna have to cut some cabinets around the fender. And that's just the way that's going to have to go. Probably going to build a box around the fender a little bit, because this is kind of tall right here. And we're going to be using this as our kitchen table, which is... So what do we got here? We got 3 feet. So 36 inches is a little tall. We're going to have some tall, like, stools, I guess, type things here. Going to try to make them as comfortable as possible. They're definitely going to have backs. That, there's no doubt about that. But this is unfortunately not going to be a kitchen table situation. We just did not have the room for it. To make this a little bit more comfortable to sit here, we're going to put this nice picture window so we can just look right out into the woods while we're sitting there eating, which is going to be nice. Nicer than staring at a wall. And this space right here is approximately... apparently it's 0 inches. That would not be the truth. It's about 5 feet. So it's about 20, 21 inches per seat. And we're going to have 3 seats here. Again, not ideal that we're not going to have a kitchen table, because we really want a place to commune and, like, you know, play a board game or just, you know, sit across from somebody. But it just was not going to work out. Ultimately, we could have had that in this space over here. But the deal is that we are planning to have a kid. And if we have a kid, we need to use this as a nursery, at least for a little while. So what this you see right here, this is like a just a temporary wall, nothing permanent. It's only 2 inches wide. And that's just going to serve as a little bit of a buffer between the kitchen and the nursery. So we're going to have a crib and some storage there. And then we're just going to have it over on this corner. We're just going to have a nice chair with the ottoman. You know, you need something. You need a nice, comfortable place to sit in a house. In like an RV or a tiny house, it can be easy just to say, oh, we need to make it all functional. We need to have storage, this and all that. And we're just going to have benches for a kitchen table. You got to have a nice, comfortable place to sit, you know, where you can like just take it easy, rest your back and just relax, be comfortable. So that's what we're going to do for now. In time, I know the section is cut off here. All right, and this is where field of view comes in really handy. Let's change that camera's field of view back to 75 degrees. Now we can actually see something that looks more like the human eye. Okay, so now we're looking at our living room. Let me back up just a little bit. Okay, just gonna move over just a little bit. Okay, so looking at our living room area, that chair is gonna be right here. Nursery crib right there. And ultimately one day we're going to have maybe like a couch over on this side when the nursery, when the crib isn't here anymore. We'll put a couch over here on this side. Let me use this tool. We'll put a couch right there, and we'll put like a chair right there. Like maybe we'll move that nice comfortable chair over to this side. And then we'll be able to, you know, have like, you know, have people come. We'll have like a little teeny coffee table or ottoman too in the center. And it's a place where people can sit and relax and talk to each other. And then if we need more space, we can always have, you know, more, we have three seats over here. People could sit there or stand where I'm standing and then talk. So that is the living room area. And okay, so before I go talk about under the stairs, let's go up the stairs and talk about what's going to be on these lofts. So we can actually, using SketchUp, we can actually walk up these stairs. And this is our smaller loft. This loft is going to be 7 foot 5.5 wide by approximately, well, not approximately, exactly 7 foot 3.5 deep. So this is going to be a small loft that, honestly, like, right out of the gate, it's not really going to be used for much. And that's something that I have a philosophical problem with. I don't like having any square footage that isn't really being used on a regular basis with multiple different uses. I feel very strongly about that. You're paying money to per square foot to build a house, and you're paying money to maintain that square footage, and you're paying money to pay taxes on that. Of course, in this house, we're not going to be paying taxes because it's not on a foundation or footings. It's on a trailer, but regardless, it all still applies. But we really don't have a use for this space. When the baby is going to be in the crib downstairs, since we don't have a place to commune, we'll probably just put some cushion, like some cushions or a beanbag up here. And this might be the place that we, like, when we have people over, we go up here, we like play a game or something. It's going to be very rare. Most of the time, we're not even going to be using this space. We're not going to use it for storage because we feel very strongly about having a minimalistic environment, very as feng shui as possible, especially in a small space. You don't want it to feel cluttered. When our kid is old enough, this will become the kid's space, like the kid's room where the kid sleeps. And, you know, there's going to be like a pony wall up here. And if we have to, we'll, like, you know, do a full wall, maybe slats or something so nobody can fall out, maybe a gate where the stairs are. The stairs, these are steep stairs. Let's actually go back down. These are some steep stairs. Each one of the risers on these stairs is 13 inches, basically, and they're only, I think, 9 inches deep. The treads are only 9 inches, so they're tough. But you know what? The alternative is having a ladder, and a ladder is, this is way better than a ladder. The way I felt about it was, if we could fit stairs, let's do the stairs, no matter what they look like. You know, it's going to be easier for a kid to possibly navigate at a younger age than a ladder would, you know, we're not too worried about the safety of our kid. You know, I think kids, they climb up trees. They climb up trees. They do all kinds of crazy stuff. I think they can get up and down a set of stairs once the time comes. In the meantime, we'll help them up or carry them up when that comes around. So the other set of stairs is a little more navigable. These guys over here, the risers are 8 3/4, basically, and the treads are 8 7/8. So basically same tread depth, around 9 inches, but the risers are substantially lower. So this is going to feel more natural, like a more natural set of stairs. Down over here, we are avoiding the fender by doing, okay, we're avoiding the fender by doing this split, like, kind of 45-degree angle stair, which is also nice because it allows us to enter the staircase from this side or from this side. Not that we couldn't do that over on this staircase, but it just makes it a little bit more ergonomic. So that was a cool solution. Underneath these stairs, there's going to be storage, maybe a little closet for coats and some other kitchen or miscellaneous storage. On this side back here, we're going to have a fridge. It's going to be a small fridge, and it is going to be, we have, I think we got about 59 inches from here to here. So, no, 62.5 inches. So we're looking at fridges that are like 57 inches and change. So we're going to build some cabinetry up underneath to hide that fender, and the fridge is going to sit on top of the fender and come up very close to these rafters right here. And I think it's like a 7 cubic foot fridge. Is that what it is? 7 cubic foot fridge and freezer we're looking at. not a whole lot bigger. It's only 1 cubic foot bigger than what we have in this camper, but that's just, we don't have the room for anything else. So yeah, these stairs right here, we have this last step is really tall. And the reason for that is it's about 1'8" when all is said and done. Whereas the rest of these steps, the risers are 8¾". So the whole idea behind that, and this wasn't our idea, we got this from other people's tiny houses, that when you're standing up on that top stair, it's very easy just to put a knee out and just crawl right into the loft. The lofts are not tall enough to stand up, so you're going to have to crawl around in them anyway. To have the stairs going all the way up to that top height of the loft, you're going to be crouching down as you're going up the stairs and then have to go too high and then back down into a crawl. So this is actually really ergonomic. We've seen other people do it in their tiny houses. It's great. So that's good. Also, these stairs are going to have vertical. This is going to be a mix of plywood and hardwood treads. So the risers are all plywood. And some of these are going to come all the way down, creating cabinetry underneath, just like we're doing over here, even though that is not depicted. Over. Yeah, I think that's... Oh, we didn't talk about the bedroom. Let's go up there real quick. So the bedroom loft, just like the other loft we talked about, it's going to have some kind of pony wall, like a little pony wall off to the side here. So a little bit of height, maybe a couple feet. We're gonna have a dresser, some type of cubbies situation, holding some clothes right here. You have a queen size bed with a little bit of space on either side. And we're going to have a flat-screen TV on a wall mount that folds out from the wall so we can watch when we want to. Pretty simple. Maybe a couple like little nightstands built in or something to the wall with some night lights or reading lights above. Something to that effect. But really simple. One other thing about the bedroom is that we are going to have blackout shades on the windows and also potentially above that pony wall from the rest of the space because I'm very light sensitive. I know Justine is pretty light sensitive too, and it's very hard to sleep. If you get to bed late, it's very hard to sleep into the day when there's light shining in your face. So I just really believe that the bedroom should be a place that can be very dark and secluded, like a little sleeping pod, when you need it to. So, that being said, I think the only other thing that I need to mention is just about our stuff. We do have a decent amount of storage in this place, not too much. The idea is that we're not going to have too much in here at all. I wouldn't say we're minimalists by any means. We have stuff. But we're trying to, especially when we came up and moved into this camper and just using the tent that you guys have seen to store our belongings, a lot of stuff that we, heirloom furniture and things that we don't want to get rid of, we want to hold on to until we move into our big house one day. We've definitely reduced the amount of stuff that we have dramatically. And we have learned that having less stuff from experience, having as little stuff as possible, as little clutter clears your head. It makes you feel better in your house. So we're going to try really hard to bring very little into this tiny house. I don't want anything out laying around at all. I'm not even going to have my computers in here. They're going to stay in the camper while we move into this tiny house. So the idea is to be very minimalistic and have everything has its place. And that's that. Nothing is laying around. We can achieve that with having some more stuff in the tent and in the camper. I think we're going to be basically just adding a few pots and pans and maybe a few other small things. But we're pretty much moving into this tiny house, which is more than 3 times the size of our camper. And we're not really adding much at all to our stuff. So it's going to work out really nicely in that way. So that's it, guys. I'm glad I was able to give you this little tour. I'm glad I actually finished drawing this thing. This was quite a process between learning SketchUp and actually doing it and having to redraw the damn thing because I had some problems in the middle of it. I'm super psyched that it's done. We're super psyched to start building this thing. And the next video that I'm going to do is I'm going to break down the framing of this place and make a material list of wood that I'm actually going to order. I'm doing that this week. I'm going to be ordering all the material, and we're literally starting to build our house in the next week or two. So, exciting times. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.